Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, president and founder of Consumer Lab, and I'm here to talk today about chia seeds. We just tested chia seed products, testing them for their nutritional value, potential contamination from heavy metals, and we did find a problem, as well as contaminants such as microbes, such as salmonella, as that has been reported to be an issue in some chia seed products around the country. Now, why are people interested in chia, and why do I like chia as well? Because chia is a tremendous source of fiber. So in a, say, one tablespoon of chia, about this much, you'll get 12 grams of chia seeds, of which about 5 grams are carbohydrates, and almost all of that is fiber. And obviously fiber is good for your gastrointestinal tract, has other benefits. So if you're trying to get more fiber into your diet, chia is a great way to go. It also has about 3 or 4 grams of good fats. Half of that is ALA, which is an omega-3 fatty acid, not quite as powerful as, say, EPA and DHA from fish oil, but an important fatty acid. It also has 2 grams of protein, and you also get some magnesium, 40 milligrams, which is about 10% of your daily value, and 75 milligrams of calcium, which is a nice contribution to your calcium. So all around, you know, chia is a really great food. Now, there are different types of chias that are sold. As you can see, if you take kind of a close look at this, you'll see that chia, most of these seeds are, they're all small. Most are black, some brown, some white. The color doesn't matter much. The white ones are immature, but they're really all not that different from the dark ones. It's not a problem. Some people want to have sprouted chia seed, and we tested whole chia seeds, ground chia seed flour. We tested sprouted chia seed that was ground as well. You can get it all these different ways. Although in our testing, what we found, unfortunately, is that one of these processed chia seed products probably wasn't just chia seed because it was contaminated with lead, which is not something we found in the other products. We also didn't find any salmonella, which is good news. But there was something very different about that particular chia seed product. When we did look at the nutritional components of each of these products, they were all virtually the same. So even if you just get a whole chia seed product, which is what I like because you can see what you're getting, it's not going to be all that different from a sprouted chia seed product. Other things to keep in mind, though, is that the cost goes up as it's more processed. So we found that you could get a good chia seed product for as little as 9 cents per tablespoon. However, if you get some other brands are more expensive, twice as expensive. Those that are processed and ground might be 4 times as expensive. In fact, one of these products was $1.33 per tablespoon. So anywhere from 9 cents to $1.33, I'd go with the 9 cents, especially if it's passed all of Consumer Lab's tests, which it did. Other things to keep in mind with chia seed is that it has a special coating on its on the seed, and that is where the fiber is. And what's cool about that is when you put it in a liquid, that fiber becomes a gel, and that causes kind of a capsule around the seed. And when you can imagine doing that with a whole tablespoon or two or three, you make a nice little pudding with chia seed, a very nutritional pudding. If you use, say, a plant-based milk that has some nice flavor to it, you have a little dessert there. It takes about 10 minutes for that expansion to start occurring. Within 15 to 20, it's kind of reached its max. So if you just add some one of these liquids to chia seed, you'll have a really nice pudding in about 20 minutes. On the other hand, that also creates a problem for anyone who has a swallowing problem. You absolutely do not want to take a tablespoon of chia seed and just swallow it and follow that with a glass of water. There was a case of a 39-year-old man who did that, and it got caught in his throat. So if you have any swallowing problems, absolutely don't do it. No one should really be eating dried chia seed. Other things to be aware of with chia is that some people can have an allergic reaction to chia, especially if they are allergic to hazelnut or sesame. And that's really about it. That's kind of what you need to know about chia. If you'd like to see how the products fared in our tests at Consumer Lab, go to our chia seed report on ConsumerLab.com. Become a member, you'll have access to all of our reports. Certainly, you can become a subscriber to our videos, so you know when we put out new reports, which we do about every 3 weeks. We've been doing this since 1999, putting out reports on all types of dietary supplements and healthy foods. And if you have any questions or comments, you can post them here where you see this video. So this is Dr. Todd Cooperman talking about one of my favorite foods, chia. But you need to be careful. If I didn't mention it earlier, we found lead in one of these products. It wasn't a huge amount of lead, but it was an amount of lead you'd want to avoid. The other products were fine. So again, Todd Cooperman with Consumer Lab. Enjoy your chia carefully. Thank you.